So, what did I do in the last week of December? Well, mostly I was tweaking stuff I already did earlier, but there are a couple of highlights. I've been interested in supporting non-ASCII identifiers and operators in LES, but understanding the Unicode standards documents is really hard. And although they publish a Unicode character database in a set of text files, it's hard to figure out how to decode the files because the format is so... Well, it's described in these insane standards documents that I mentioned, which are immense, and they are really good at hiding information in there. Every once in a while, I go in there, and I try to figure it out, but only now have I actually succeeded, at least partially. I figured out how to get some attributes of each character, including the character category, and I even figured out that there are standard .NET APIs to get the same information. But the .NET does not support Unicode properly. .NET treats Unicode characters as 16 bits, when in fact they are 20.09 bits. You see, they are 17 planes of 16 bits each, which is 20.09 bits. So I made this page where I could look at all the Unicode characters in the world. At first, it was a table of two columns with ranges on one side and characters on the other. That version crashed Chrome, but that's fine, because then I made this better version that wasn't based on a table. And then I tweaked it so you could collapse sections. And then I tweaked it again so that there were these new buttons which would like collapse or expand groups of things for you. And then I added these checkboxes so you could see it in bold or italic or whatever, or sans serif. And there's a link to this page in the video description. And then I was thinking to myself that you should be able to try lemp on the command line without bothering with an input file. So I added this dash dash eval command line option. All it does is parse an expression and run lemp on it. So here's an example of defining a macro inside the eval command and then calling the macro in the same eval command. Just don't forget that you normally need quotes around the entire argument. Use single quotes in bash or PowerShell and double quotes on the Windows command line.